Juan Gomez, the last man to see Jose Gasparilla alive. I was a young member of his crew on that fateful day when he wrapped himself in an anchor and plunged into the Gulf. I escaped that day and lived many years in the Florida wilderness, south of Naples, back in the land of 10,000 islands up the Shark River on Panther Key. I was a fisherman for many, many years and became known as Panther Key John. For years, I have told the stories and the legend of the pirate Jose Gasparilla. Jose Gasparilla marauded the Gulf Coast of Florida and the Caribbean Sea between 1778 to 1821. He and his crew of Spanish pirates lived and hid among the islands known as Gasparilla's Pirate Kingdom. From there, they fiercely attacked the gold-laden ships of the Spanish Main and the unsuspecting merchant ships that sailed the Gulf waters. Their bounty was rich and plentiful. The barrier islands of Charlotte Harbor were once the home of Captain Gasparilla and other pirates. These islands of Gasparilla's Pirate Kingdom were a convenient hideaway for pirates from 1780s to 1820s. They were only a short sail to the rich treasures of the Spanish Main and the Caribbean Sea. Fellow pirates were free to settle and live in these islands, always under the watchful eye of Jose Gasparilla. Almost 40 years of pirating came to an end December 21st, 1821. Jose Gasparilla and his crew attacked a slow-moving merchant ship off the coast of Gasparilla Island. As the attack began, Gasparilla soon realized this was no defenseless merchant vessel, but rather a naval ship disguised, sent to capture him and his crew. Jose Gasparilla quickly understood the battle was lost. 40 years of pirating had been a good life, but now he was trapped at the bow of his sinking ship. Feeling the inevitable, he wrapped himself in the anchor chain and he raised his sword and said, "No man will determine my fate. Only I will choose my destiny." Then he threw himself into the waters of the Gulf of Mexico, never to be found again. The mystic crew of Gasparilla has honored the legacy of Jose Gasparilla and his crew with an annual pirate invasion of Tampa aboard this pirate ship. During the early years of the crew, many different pirate ships were used for the invasion. Various personal boats and questionable merchant vessels have served as our pirate ship. In 1954, the crew commissioned the Jose Gasparilla for construction. For more than 65 years, this fully rigged pirate ship has led the armed pirate invasion of Tampa. It all started in May of 1904. The first parade celebrating Tampa was held as part of the spring celebration for citizens and visitors. The pirate Jose Gasparilla was reported to have explored this area of Florida during his time along this coast. And therefore, the city memorialized the pirate legend, and the annual parade was named Gasparilla. Every January, the Gasparilla season begins with the pirate ship leading an invading armada of hundreds of boats into downtown Tampa. The attacking pirates demand the key from the mayor. After receiving the key, the pirates host a massive parade on Bayshore Boulevard for nearly a half million people, all ending in a world-class street party open to everyone. The Bayshore Boulevard Gasparilla Parade is one of the largest parades in the country, and the annual invading armada of boats is the largest in the United States. We honor you, Captain Jose Gasparilla, and we swear to continue patrolling these waters in your absence.